Demographics of Guatemala. The demographics of Guatemala are diverse. The 17,263,239 people, 2018 estimate, consist primarily of Mestizos, Amerindians, and people of European descent. The population is divided almost evenly between rural and urban areas. About 65% of the population speaks Spanish, with nearly all the rest speaking Amerindian languages. There are 23 officially recognized Amerindian languages. According to official 2012 national statistics, 39.8% of the population is indigenous. According to the total population estimate within, the proportion of the population below the age of 15 in 2010 was 41.5%, 54.1% were aged between 15 and 65 years of age, and 4.4% were aged 65 years or older. Guatemala City is home to almost 3 million inhabitants. In 1900, Guatemala had a population of 885,000. Over the 20th century, Guatemala's population grew by a factor of 14. Even though Guatemala's population grew by a factor of 14, it still wasn't the biggest jump in that region. Although Guatemala does have an increase in population, the annual population isn't the superior in that region of the world as well. In Guatemala, there are 22 departments that make up the country. Each department has its own population, with Guatemala City ranking at 1 with the highest population and El Progreso ranking at 22 with the lowest population. According to the table, Guatemala City accounts for 20% of the entire population in Guatemala, while El Progreso only accounts for 0.14% of the population. Sololá accounts for 2.7% of the population while ranking in the middle at 11. Overall, the rankings correlate to the percent of the population that each department contains. The Guatemalan Civil War from 1960 to 1996 led to mass emigration, particularly Guatemalan immigration to the United States. According to the International Organization for Migration, the total number of emigrants increased from 6,700 in the 1960s to 558,776 for the period 1995 to 2000 semicolon by 2005. The total number had reached 1.3 million. In 2013, the Migration Policy Institute, MPI, estimated that there were about 900,000 Guatemalan Americans persons of Guatemalan origin in the United States. Official 2012 statistics indicate that approximately 60.2% of the population is non-indigenous, referring to the mestizo population and the people of European origin. These people are called Ladino in Guatemala. Approximately 39.8% of the population is indigenous and consist of 23 Maya groups and one non-Maya group. These are divided as follows: Quiché 9.1%, 8.4% Coxichal, Mam 7.9%, 6.3% Quechí, other Maya peoples 8.6%, 0.2% indigenous non-Maya. They live all over the country, especially in the highlands. Other racial groups include numbers of Afro-Guatemalans, Afro-Mestizos, and Garifuna of mixed African and indigenous Caribbean origins who live in the country's eastern end. Some Garifunas live mainly in Livingston, San Vicente, and Puerto Barrios. They descend mainly from the Arawaks and Belizean Creoles. There are thousands of Arab Guatemalans descending from Palestine, Syria, Jordan, Iraq, and other Arab countries who reside in Guatemala City. Some belong to Christian churches while others to Islamic mosques. There are also thousands of Jews residing in Guatemala. They are immigrants from Germany and Eastern Europe that arrived in the 19th century. Many immigrated during World War II. There are approximately 9,000 Jews living in Guatemala today. Most live in Guatemala City, Quetzaltenango, and San Marcos. Today, the Jewish community in Guatemala is made up of Orthodox Jews, Sephardi, Eastern European, and German Jews. In 2014, numerous members of the Hasidic communities leave Tahor and Tuarez Hasid began settling in the village of San Juan La Laguna. The mainstream Jewish community was reportedly dismayed and concerned that the arrival of communities with a more visible adherence to Judaism might stir up anti-Jewish sentiment. Despite the tropical heat, the members of the community continued to wear the traditional ancient Jewish clothing. Asian Guatemalans are primarily of Korean descent and Chinese descent, whose ancestors were farm workers and railroad laborers in the early 20th century. The Mayan civilization ruled Guatemala and the surrounding regions until around 1000 AD. Following 1000 AD, Guatemala became a Spanish colony for approximately three centuries, until in 1821 when Guatemala won its independence. Since the independence of Guatemala, the country has experienced a wide range of governments, including civilian and military governments. In 1996, a peace treaty was signed by the government that ended internal conflicts within the region, which caused over 200,000 casualties and approximately 1 million refugees. Approximately 18.5% of the population is considered white or Caucasian, accounts for more than 3 million of the population. Most are of Spanish or German descent, but there is a considerable number of people of Italian, Belgian, French, British, Swiss, Finnish, Russian, and Hungarian descent. The departments of Zacapa and Chiquimula are half or predominantly of Spanish descent, with Castizos, the white populations make up more than 80% in these departments, where many European immigrants arrived, mainly the 19th and 20th centuries. In Guatemala City there is a significant amount of minority descendants of Europeans, 35-40%, and other minorities with more than 20% in Coban, Carlos V, and Xelajú. Guatemalan mestizos are people of mixed European and indigenous ancestry. The mestizo population is heavily populated in urban areas of the country, the national capital and departmental capitals. Historically, the mestizo population in the Kingdom of Guatemala at the time of independence amounted to nearly 600,000 Indians, 300,000 Costas, mostly mestizos and a lesser number of mulattoes, zambos, and pardos, and 45,000 criollos or Spanish, with a very small number of Spaniards. The Amerindian populations in Guatemala include the Quiché 9.1%, Cochicol 8.4%, Mam 7.9% and Quechí 6.3%. 8.6% belongs to other Maya groups, 0.4% belonged non-Maya indigenous peoples. The whole indigenous community in Guatemala is about 40.5% of the population. The official language of Guatemala is Spanish. It is spoken by nearly 93% of the population and is found mainly in the departments of the Southern Region, Eastern Region, Guatemala City and Petén. Though the official language is Spanish, it is often the second language among the indigenous population. Approximately 23 additional Amerindian languages are spoken by more than 40% of the population. 21 Mayan languages, 1 indigenous, and 1 Arawakan are spoken in Guatemala. The most significant are Quiché, Cochicol, Quechí, Mam, Garífuna, and Xhaka. There are also significant numbers of German, Chinese, French and English speakers. Catholicism was the official religion during the colonial era. Protestantism has increased in recent decades. More than one-third of Guatemalans are Protestant, chiefly evangelicals and Pentecostals. Eastern and Oriental Orthodoxy claim rapid growth, especially among indigenous Mayans. The Islamic community in Guatemala is growing. Muslim population of Guatemala is approximately 1,200. Of this population, 95% are Palestinian Arab immigrants. There is a mosque in the outskirts of Guatemala City called the Islamic Dao Mosque of Guatemala, Spanish, Mezquita de la Altoa Islamica, which is available for the five daily prayers and offers classes in Islamic studies. The president of the Islamic community of the country is Jamal Mubarak. Traditionally, a large proportion of Guatemalans have been Catholics. This has declined, from 90% of the population in 1950, 61% in 1986, 65% in 1991, after the visit of the Pope John Paul II, 57% in 2006, and 47% in 2013. Between 1882 and 1940, 2% of the population were Protestants, 17.98% were Protestant in 1978, 30% in 1986, 21% in 1991, 25.27% in 2001, 30.70% in 2006 and 40% Protestant in 2014. 3% of Guatemalans follow other religions. 9% are non-religious. Guatemalans who self-identify as atheists/agnostics were 3.25% of the population in 1982, 12% in 1991, and 9.9% in 2006. According to the Latino Barometro, 8% of the population were irreligious in 1996, 15% in 2000, 16% in 2007, 11% in 2008, 13% in 2010, with 10% irreligious in 2014. The other religions were 9% in 1996 to 14% 1 year later, and 3% in 2013. The Population Department of the United Nations prepared the following estimates. Over the course of 60 years, live births per year has increased by a factor of 2.6, while the deaths per year has only increased by a factor of 1.0. This suggests that the natural change per year has increased by a factor of 3.9. The crude birth rate has decreased from 50.3 births per 1,000 population to only 33.3 births per 1,000 population. Meanwhile, the crude death rate has decreased from 22.3 deaths per 1,000 population to 5.6 deaths per 1,000 population. The CDR and CBR correlate to the rate of natural change, which has fluctuated over the 60-year time period. The total fertility rate has decreased from 7.00 children per woman to 4.15 children per woman, and the infant mortality rate decreased from 141 infant deaths per 1,000 live births to 30 infant deaths per 1,000 live births. The TFR decreases due to the decreased IMR. Lastly, the table shows the total life expectancy for males and/or females. Overall, the total life expectancy has increased from approximately 43 years to approximately 70 years. Total fertility rate, TFR, wanted fertility rate, and crude birth rate, CBR. Structure of the population, January 7, 2005, estimates. Structure of the population, January 7, 2010, estimates, projections based on the 2002 population census. Structure of the population, 2015. The legal age for females to get married in Guatemala is 14, with parental consent. This phenomenon, known as child marriage, is prevalent in Central America. In rural areas of Guatemala, 53% of 20 to 24-year-old women married before their 18th birthday. Once married, young girls are likely to abandon their education and are exposed to domestic and sexual violence. They are no longer seen as girls. Their husbands, who are often older men, see them as servants. Frequently births are at home. Most of these women are isolated without networks of support. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.